Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama 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 Hari Hari
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna
This class was meant for the Malaysian youth.
这堂课本来应该是给马来西亚的年轻人讲的。Right,
we were supposed to speak about the importance of the youth in our Krishna consciousness movement.
我们将谈论一下这个年轻人在 Krishna 知觉运动之中的重要性。And
so those of you who are not in that category, you're welcome to stay in here.
那些不属于这个范畴的人，我们也欢迎你待在这听课。But
just trying to appreciate why I'm speaking so much about the youth.
但你们可以努力的去欣赏，为什么我要很多的谈论跟年轻人有关的事。All
right, we want to point out that the youth are the future of our Krishna consciousness movement.
我们想指出，年轻人是我们 Krishna 知觉运动的未来。And
we want that we have that we give all facility to encourage the youth to come forward and take more responsibility in the Krishna consciousness movement.
我们要提供便利条件，要鼓励这些年轻人在 Krishna 知觉运动之中担当起更大的责任来。
We need to have more and more leaders for the Krishna consciousness movement.
我们需要为 Krishna 知觉运动准备越来越多的领袖们。
We can see the number of devotees growing.
我们可以看到奉献者的数量在不断增加。And
of course we would like it to continue to grow.
当然了，我们喜欢让这个数目不断的增加。But
the people who can contribute the most to the development of our Krishna consciousness movement are the youth.
但是能够为我们 Krishna 知觉运动不断发展壮大提供力量的是年轻人。In
Srila Prabhupada's time, most of the devotees, more than 90% of the devotees were all in their teens and 20s.
在舍帕帕德的那个时代，绝大多数的奉献者，他们都是青少年，最多是二十几岁。
And younger.
更年轻。
But when Prabhupada was asked about it, why is it our Krishna consciousness movement is attracting so many young people?
有人问释了帕帕，为什么这个昆士兰拒绝运动吸引了这么多的年轻人？
Prabhupada responded, he said, because that is a time for education.
Prabhupada 回答说，因为这就是教育的时间。
So, Srila Prabhupada was stressing the importance of our Krishna consciousness movement to give education to people.
Srila Prabhupada 强调，我们的昆士兰知觉运动主要是为了为人们提供教育。
Not that we just come and chant Hare Krishna, eat prasadam, and go away.
并不是我们来了之后唱诵 Hare Krishna, 吃 prasadam, 然后就走了。
But we want to also educate the people that they will understand the philosophy.
我们想要教育人们，让他们能够理解哲学。
And they can present it and convince others about the philosophy.
而且他们能够把这个哲学呈现给别人，去说服别人。
When Srila Prabhupada went to Geneva in Switzerland, it was in the year 1974. It was 50 years ago.
当Srila Prabhupada去瑞士日内瓦的时候呢，是1974年，也就是50年之前。
So they arranged for Prabhupada to meet with the mayor of Geneva.
他们安排让Srila Prabhupada见日内瓦的市长。
So the mayor had seen our Krishna conscious devotees, you know, Geneva's not a very big city, you know, and the devotees were seen regularly in the main parts of the town, in this, well, you call it a city, not really a city, it's like a town, but anyway, the devotees would be seen everywhere, and so the mayor was noticing how people, these Hare Krishna people are there, everywhere.
市长已经见过了奉献者，因为这个日内瓦并不是一个很大的城市，我们宁可说它像一个小镇一样，而这个奉献者们他们经常的出去，所以这个日内瓦的市长就发现奉献者们怎么到处都在。
And he noticed that they were all young people.
他注意到大家都是年轻人。
So the mayor said to Srila Prabhupada,What will happen when everybody becomes a Hare Krishna devotee?
市长就问说 Prabhupada, 如果每一个人都成为了 Hare Krishna 奉献者，会发生什么样的事情？
Because the mayor was only seeing the devotees in the street doing Sankirtan and distributing books.
因为市长只看到奉献者们在大街上做 Sankirtan, 然后派发书籍。
So the mayor was thinking that Hare Krishna people just only do that.
市长就想 Hare Krishna 的人只做这个。
They just wander in the streets and they chant and dance and they distribute books.
他们只是在大街上漫游、唱诵、跳舞、派书。
But Srila Prabhupada explained to the mayor that in the Vedic culture there are four different varnas or occupational duties.
但是舍帕帕德向市长解释到，在伟大的文化之中呢，有四种 varna, 也就是四种职业。
And Prabhupada explained to the mayor how there's the brahmana class of people who are intellectual and who like to study and teach.
舍帕帕德向市长解释说，有一阶层的人，他们叫做知识分子 brahmana 们，他们学习然后教别人。
And there are the intellectual class of.Rather, the administrative class of people who like to manage affairs.
还有一种行政管理人员，他们负责管理事务。
And then you have the business people, the mercantile, the Vaishya people who may do farming and trading and banking.
然后还有做商业贸易的人，他们就是去做一些银行业、贸易以及农业。
And then finally, you have the working class, the sutra people.
最后还有劳工阶层呢，就是书者。
So everyone is engaged according to their propensities.
每个人按照他们的倾向都有合适的活动来做。
So Prabhupada was explaining to the mayor that not everybody, if everyone may become a Hare Krishna, but it doesn't mean they'll just be in the street singing and dancing.And distributing books.
帕帕德向市长解释说，如果每一个人都成为了 Hare Krishna 的奉献者的话，并不意味着每一个人都在大街上又唱又跳，然后派书。
And we can see today how our Hare Krishna movement has developed.
That
there's not many people singing and dancing and distributing books. But most people are working in a job or doing business somewhere.
绝大多数人都有工作，他们去上班，然后呢做生意。
Some people may be also managerial type. They may be even in the military, working in the army or something.
有的人他们在管理阶层做工作，或者有的人他们在军队之中。
And then you've got some people who are brahminical. They may be working. They may be doing.The pujari work in the temple, or they may be teaching in a school.
还有一些 Brahmana 们，他们可能是在庙里崇拜神像，或者是在学校里教书。
So they're also Hare Krishna devotees.
他们也是 Hare Krishna 奉献者。
If they're chanting Hare Krishna, if they're regularly worshipping Krishna, then they're also devotees.
如果他们唱诵 Hare Krishna, 他们有规律地去崇拜 Krishna, 他们也是奉献者。
So Prabhupada was always laughing about how the mayor was worried that what will happen if all the young people become Hare Krishnas.
除了 Prabhupada, 他其实就在笑，因为市长太担心了，如果每一个人都成为 Hare Krishna 的奉献者会怎么样？
Of course, that will be very nice. That is our dream.
当然，那是非常美好的一件事情，那是我们的梦想。
We want to see all the young people become Hare Krishna devotees.
我们希望看到所有的年轻人都成为 Hare Krishna 奉献者。
How to attract them?
如何吸引他们？
Of course, they may be fortunate that they may be born in a devotee family.
当然，如果他们幸运的话，可能是出生在奉献者的家庭。
Those children born in a devotee family, then from their very birth, they have the opportunity to regularly go to temple.
那些非常幸运能够出生在奉献者之家的人，他们就可以有机会经常的去庙。
And they may be favorable to the Krishna consciousness movement.
他们可能会对 Krishna 知觉运动很有好感。
But they may not be very committed to Krishna consciousness.
但他们可能并不是特别的承诺于 Krishna 知觉的修习。
But we want to encourage the young people to make a commitment to Krishna consciousness.
我们想鼓励年轻人对 Krishna 知觉进行承诺。
To try to get them to become active in Krishna consciousness.
我们想让他们在 Krishna 知觉之中活跃起来。
Of course, sometimes young people think, oh, I want to be a doctor, I want to be a lawyer.
有的时候年轻人们就会想，我想成为一个医生，或者是我想成为一个律师。
Of course, today, a lot of people, they just want to be computer programmers.
当然了，如今有很多的人，他们都想成为电脑程序员。
They go to school, they go on to college, they get a degree.And then they go and look for the job.
他们先上学，然后就上大学，之后得到了文凭呢，就努力地找工作。
And Prabhupada describes what it's like when they graduate from college. He explained what kind of attitude they have to have.
帕帕德就解释了，当他们毕业之后，他们去找工作，他们是什么样子的，也就是他们应该有什么样的态度。
You have to go door to door to the different companies.
你要挨家挨户的去不同的公司。
And you have to knock on their door.
你要敲他们的门。
And say, my dear sir, please give me a job.
并且你要说，我亲爱的先生，求你了，给我一份工作吧。
I will be a good dog for you.
我会成为你的一条好狗。
Yes, you have to have the doggish mentality.
是吧？你必须得有这种像当狗一样的心态。
You have to beg, my dear sir, please let you give me the job. Let me work for you.
你得去祈求，我亲爱的先生，请给我一份工作吧，请让我为你工作吧。
And you, often you have to work for wicked and miserly people.
而且经常你会为那些邪恶而吝啬的人而工作。
So A lot of young people, they don't think about these things.
很多的年轻人并不考虑这些事情。
We try to warn them what it's like.
我们努力地去警告他们会成什么样的情况。
What is the material world?
物质世界到底是什么样子的？
How you have to put up with these kind of situations.
你如何要面对所有这些不同的状况？
Working for horrible, nasty, miserly, sinful people.
为那些非常可怕的、非常罪恶的、非常吝啬的、邪恶的人而工作。
And associating with all these kind of people.
而且是跟所有这样的人一起有关系。
So we try to encourage young people to appreciate the association of devotees.
因此，我们想去劝说这些年轻人们关于跟奉献者一起联谊的重要性。
And we do things like we have special youth programs.
我们会组织一些特殊的年轻人的活动。
In Thailand, just last year, we had a tour. We made a tour with the young Thai devotees.
在泰国，我们跟那些年轻的泰国年轻人一起组织了一个旅行。
Yeah, we had a group of young Thai devotees. They were all children.That their parents were devotees and they were in the Krishna consciousness movement because their parents were devotees.
我们就组织这些泰国的年轻人一起旅行，他们的父母是奉献者，所以他们也成奉献者。
So we took them to different cities in Thailand where we had centers and where devotees were, and we made programs.
我们就带着他们访问泰国不同的中心。因为就是为了组织一些节目，让他们更好的成为奉献者。
Devotees, they travel. I traveled with them, and we went to these different cities. We would do some Harinam Sankirtan, some book distribution.
我们一起旅行，我们去一个城市，一起做 Harinam Sankirtan， 然后一起派书。
And we met the devotees in the different cities.
我们去见那些不同城市的奉献者们。
And in this way, the young devotees got an opportunity to travel and to see the different parts of Thailand.
这样，年轻的奉献者们就可以有机会旅行，去游览一下泰国不同的地方。
And to see how the devotees are trying to preach in these different places.
并且去看不同的奉献者在所有不同的地方如何传播。
Similarly, in the USA, every year.They have a program for the young, for the youth there.
同样道理，在美国，大家也会组织一年一度的年轻人的活动。
They have a special bus which accommodates the youth, and they go around the USA and Canada during the summer months.
他们有特殊的巴士，也就是说，在夏天的那个月份之中呢，他会带着这些年轻人去美国还有加拿大旅行。
And they're able to attend Rathyatras in different cities and festivals like Janmashtami and Radhastami.
他们就带着这些年轻的路线者一起去参加 Rathyatra 弹车节，参与Janmashtami 还各种节日。
And in this way, they get association with many other.Devotees in different parts of the world.
这样他们就可以得到来自于世界不同地方的奉献者们的联谊。
They meet the sannyasis in different places, and they meet the temple presidents.
他们见不同地方的 sannyasi 还有庙长。
And they see also the restaurants which are there in different places.
而且他们还去看一看在各个不同地方的餐厅。
It's important.For the devotees to see that there's a future in being a member of the Krishna consciousness movement.
重要的是要让奉献者们看到，如果你成为 Krishna 知觉运动之中的一员，你是有未来的。
Young people they're thinking, I need to have a future. I need to get a good job.
年轻人就在想，我需要一个美好的未来，我要找工作。
But you can have a nice future in the Krishna consciousness movement.
但是你在 Krishna 知觉运动之中也可以有美好的未来。
Especially we see here in Malaysia nice examples of people who joined the movement when they were very young.
而且尤其是在马来西亚，我们可以看到很好的榜样，有一些人他们很年轻就加入了 Krishna 聚觉。
For example, Kripasindu Krishna Prabhu, the temple president of Kuala Lumpur and also of Kuching.
比如说有 Kripasindu Krishna Prabhu, 他是吉隆坡以及 Kuching 的庙长。
Yeah, he's overseeing two temples.
他在照管着两座庙。
And he is very active in preaching Krishna consciousness.
他非常活跃地在传播 Krishna 知觉。
He is the secretary for the Malaysia Hindu Sangam in Sarawak.
他是在 Sarawak 的马来西亚印度教徒桑格的一个秘书。
Sarawak is West Malaysia. We are in the East Malaysia. He's in Sarawak, West Malaysia.
Sarawak 是在West Malaysia, 是在马来西亚的西部。我们现在是在马来西亚的东部。
Or maybe it's the other way.
要不然就是
Sarawak East.
Sarawak 是东边，然后咱们现在在西边。
This is west.
这个是西边。
And then, so he's the Malaysia Hindu Sangam secretary for Sarawak.
这个是 Sarawak 这个地方的马来西亚的印度桑格的秘书。
It's quite a position to have in the Hindu community.
在印度社团之中，这是相当有身份的一个地位。
He's been in the Krishna consciousness movement for 40 years.
他已经加入了 Krishna 知觉运动40年。
He's had the best education in Krishna consciousness.
他得到了 Krishna 知觉之中最好的教育。
Working for Krishna, preaching Krishna consciousness.
为 Krishna 而工作，传播 Krishna 知觉。
And he is respected in the Hindu community.
而且他在印度社团之中受到大家的尊敬。
And then you have Shiva Chaitanya Prabhu. He also joined Krishna consciousness as a very young man.
还有 Shiva Chaitanya Prabhu, 他很年轻的时候加入了 Krishna 知觉。
And he's the co-president of our Todu Temple up in Seprangjaya.
然后他是我们 Seprangjaya 的 Todu 庙的联席庙长。
And then you have Mahavaraha Prabhu, he is the secretary and a very intimate servant of Srila Jayapataka Swami Maharaj.
还有 Mahavaraha, 他是 Srila Jayapataka Swami Maharaj 的秘书以及特别贴身的一个仆人。
He's been traveling with him for more than 20 years.
他跟他一起旅行了20多年。
So he joined the Krishna consciousness movement also as a young boy.
他也是还是很年轻的时候就加入了 Krishna 知觉运动。
But he's had so much experience, so much opportunity for intimate association.With such senior devotees.
但他非常的有经验，他跟这么高级的奉献者有很深度密切的联谊。
So my point is that there's a great future if you join the Krishna consciousness movement.
我的要点是，如果你加入 Krishna 知觉运动的话，你会有一个非常美好的未来。
We are building the temples.
我们在建设庙宇。
And these temples are for you. You're the youth of Malaysia.
而建这些庙是为了你们，你们是马来西亚的年轻人。
You have to take over the future of these temples.
你们要主管这些庙宇的未来。
You have to look after them and develop them.
你们要好好的去照管这些庙宇，并且发展这些庙宇。
We are just doing only the beginning, the making the foundation.
我们只能是做一个开始，打下基础。
But it's for the youth, the young people, that as they grow up, they can help take these temples and develop them more.
但只有年轻人，等你们长大成熟之后，你们来掌管这些庙宇，然后做出更大的发展。
We have more and more people need Krishna consciousness.
我们需要有越来越多的人都变得具有 Krishna 知觉。
After COVID, more and more people are feeling the need for spirituality.
在新冠之后，有越来越多的人感觉他们需要灵性的这种渴求。
People are realizing how insecure the material world is.
他们认识到这个物质世界是多么的不安全。
And they're thinking about the future.
而且在他们在考虑未来。
And they can see the material world has no future to offer.
他们可以看到这个物质世界根本不能提供什么未来。
But the Krishna consciousness movement can give a real future.
但是 Krishna 拒绝运动才能够给人真正的未来。
So Srila Prabhupada was preaching in India for many years. He was trying to get people to help him.
释迦牟尼佛在印度传播 Krishna 拒绝很多年，他努力地想让人来帮助他。
And he would go to people and say,You have nice young men, young sons. Why don't you give one son to me?
他去别的人家里面说，你有非常好的这个儿子，很年轻的，非常好的儿子，为什么不把一个儿子给我呢？
And they would say, Oh, Swamiji, my son, I want him to be the lawyer.
他们就会说 ，Oh, Swamiji, 我的儿子，我想让他当律师。
My son, I want him to be engineer.
我的儿子，我想让他以后当工程师。
And Prabhupada would say, No, I will take him, make him a Bhagavad Gita preacher. Let him preach Bhagavad Gita.
但是释迦牟尼佛就说，我会把他带走，把他变成一个 Bhagavad Gita 的传播者，让他去传播 Bhagavad Gita.
But they would say, Oh, Swamiji, my son, he wants to.Have a nice material life.
然后他们会说，哦，斯瓦米吉，我的儿子，他想要一个非常美好的物质生活。
Where are you going to get this nice material life?
你到哪儿去能找到美好的物质生活？
You will not find any place in the material world where you will get a nice, comfortable life.
在物质世界里，你找不到任何的地方能为你提供舒适美好的生活。
Everywhere it is a temporary place full of misery.
每一个地方都是短暂的地方，然后充满了痛苦。
Everywhere there is old age, disease, and death.
每一个地方都有生老病死。
So, we encourage people to come to the Krishna consciousness movement.
所以我们鼓励大家加入我们的 Krishna 拒绝运动。
Come and be engaged in spiritual activities.
来从事于灵性的活动。
And then as a devotee, it doesn't matter if you live or if you die.
而且作为奉献者根本没有关系，是活着还是死了都没关系。
We say jivava maravyat sadhu.Jivada Marada Vado. If you live or if you die, if you're the devotee, it doesn't matter.
如果你是一个奉献者，无论是活着还是死了都没有关系。
Because you live, you will serve Krishna, and if you die, you'll go and serve Krishna some other place.
因为如果你活着，你可以服务 Krishna. 如果你死了的话，你可以去另外的地方服务 Krishna.
But if you're the butcher, or if you're a hunter.Then don't live and don't die.
但如果你是个屠夫或者你是个猎人，那就既不能活着也不能死。
Because you're living in hell, and when you die, you go to hell.
因为你活着的时候你就身处地狱之中，等你死了之后你更要下地狱。
So we have to understand Krishna consciousness is offering the positive alternative to life.
所以我们应该明白 Krishna 知觉为我们提供生活的一个肯定的一个选择。
And it's very important to try to get the youth as early as possible into Krishna consciousness.
而且让年轻人越早越接触 Krishna 知觉越好。
Prahlad Maharaj said, Koma acharit pratno dharmam bhagavatam iha. That now you're Kumar. Kumar means the young boy up to the age of 5. Then they're at the stage of Kumar.
Prahlad Maharaj said Kumar, 意思就是说这个年龄段一直到五岁，这样的被称为是 Kumar.
It's the first stage of life. And from that point, they should begin learning Bhagavad Dharma.
就是生命的第一个阶段，从这个时候开始，人就应该学习巴格瓦达尔玛。
I certainly felt like that when I joined the Krishna consciousness movement.
当我加入 Krishna 拒绝运动的时候，我肯定是有这样的感觉。
I joined the Krishna consciousness movement, 1971.
我是1971年加入 Krishna 拒绝的。
So I was already 22, I think.
我想我当时已经22岁了。
So, I was thinking, oh, if only I had joined Krishna consciousness before.
当时我就想，我要是能早点加入 Krishna 知觉就好了。
Sometimes people would ask me, what age were you when you became a devotee? And I would tell them, oh, I was 22, or they say, oh, so young, you became a devotee so young. But I thought I became a devotee, I'm so old.
有的时候人们问我，你是十多大了你就加入 Krishna 之学了，我说呢我22岁，大家都说哦你那么年轻就加入了，但你知道我是怎么想的，我想我怎么这么老了才加入啊。
If only I'd known about Krishna consciousness before, I wouldn't have wasted so much time in mundane education.
我就在想，如果我早知道 Krishna 之学的话，我根本不浪费这么多的时间在世俗的教育上。
Mundane education, which is, you know, you study, you go to university, you study, everything you learn a few years later, useless. It's all out of date.
你去上大学的时候学很多的东西，你一毕业过几年之后，所有这些东西都没有用处了，都过时了。
Everything you learn.
你学习的所有的一切。
In the course of time, the technology changes, the philosophy changes, the knowledge changes.
所有的一切，这种科技在改变，然后哲学在改变，知识也在改变。
Just like they teach things, they used to teach the world is flat. Then later on they thought, no, the world is not flat, the world is round.
就像一开始的时候他们教育大家整个的这个世界是一个平的一个平面，之后他们说不是一个平面，是一个球状的。
They're still trying to figure out what is the real nature of the universe.
现在大家还在继续的探讨到底这个宇宙的真正的本性是什么。
In the beginning they had the corpuscular theory that everything is corpuscle, that there's just like little cells andThis is how they explained the atom.
在一开始的时候，他们还有一种特殊的理论，然后就是说，所有的一切都是由很小很小的原子构成的。
And then they came up with the wave theory.
然后他们又出现了一种叫做波形理论。
And then they came with the atomic theory, different levels of energy.
然后他们有了这种不同层那个能量的层级的理论。
And they still haven't come to any proper conclusion to explain about life.
直到现在，他们还没有达成任何恰当的结论来解释生命的存在。
It's all useless knowledge.
这些全都是没有用处的知识。
But people dedicate their life to studying all these things.
可是有人花了一辈子的时间去学习这些东西。
And they spend a fortune to.Learn all this garbage.
而且他们花很多的钱来学习这些垃圾。
So we're encouraging people come to Krishna consciousness and learn spiritual knowledge.
因此我们鼓励这些人加入 Krishna 之学，学习灵性的知识。
Come and study the Bhagavad Gita.
来学习 Bhagavad Gita.
People, of course, try to learn the Bhagavad Gita. They read it for themselves. They try to understand it. They never get anywhere.
当然人们试图自己去理解巴格瓦吉塔，他们试图自己去学习，但是他们达不成什么结果。
They try to read it, they cannot understand what it's about.
他们努力的去阅读，可是他们却不能够理解这到底是讲了什么。
But when you get connected to the real devotees, then the message becomes very clear.
但是如果你跟真正的奉献者有关系的话，这个信息就会变得很清晰。
I had the experience myself. I studied Bhagavad Gita when I was a student.
我自己就有这方面的体验。我还上学的时候，我就学习过 Bhagavad Gita.
I couldn't understand what it was about.
我根本就不能够理解这到底是什么。
But as soon as I started going to the Krishna Conscious Center in London,Every evening I would hear the Bhagavad Gita from some young teenage brahmachari and it would all make perfect sense.
后来我是在伦敦加入了 Krishna 之学之后呢，我就去庙里听课，每天晚上很年轻的，就是有点像青少年那个阶段的 brahmachari 们讲课，我觉得他们讲得特别好。
But you hear it from somebody who's not a devotee, certainly the message will not be understood.
但如果你从一个非奉献者那里聆听，你就不明白这个 信息到底是什么。
So we're trying to give people this Krishna conscious message.
所以我们想努力的把这个 Krishna 知觉的讯息去。
And Prabhupada said, we need many young people to come forward and be trained to teach this knowledge.
帕帕德说，我们需要很多的年轻人，让他们得到训练，然后传播这门知识。
You come and give this life to Krishna, you'll never regret it.
你们来了，把你们的生命献给 Krishna， 永远不会后悔。
But you give your life to some multinational corporation, you suffer.
但如果你们把你们的一辈子交给一个跨国大公司，你就等着受苦吧。
You work for some big corporation, it's just the rat race.
那么你就去了一个大公司去工作，这个属于老鼠的这种恩赐。
I was in India and I was in New Delhi and Gurgaon there's a lot of big skyscraper buildings there and all the multinational companies have their offices there.
我曾经在印度新德里的 Gurgaon 地方这个地区待过，然后这个地方有很多的摩天大楼，全都是跨国的大公司。
So we had a program there and this one young lady came and she told me how she'd work very hard to get a job in that place.
我们在这个地方组织了一个节目，来了一个女士，然后这个女士就告诉我们，她特别努力的工作，想在这个地方就是找到一份工作。
She had to go, you know, many interviews and many different tests they would give.
她参加很多的面试，人家给她进行很多考试。
Finally, she got a job, and she thought, oh.I've got the job, I'm working for a big company, my life is a success.
终于他得到了一份工作，然后他就想，现在我在为一个大公司工作，我的生命成功了。
But after she'd been in the company for a short time, she realized how horrible it all was.
但是呢，当他在这个大公司里工作了一小段时间之后，他就发现这一切是多么的可怕。
Just suffering, so many nasty people all fighting and quarreling with each other.
有很多特别恶心的人，整天互相的争斗。
There was no harmony, there was no cooperation.
根本没有和谐，没有合作。
Everyone, each person was trying to get to the top over another person.
每一个人都想把别人踩在自己脚底下。
Prabhupada saw, he went to Japan.And he met the people in Japan, the printing company, Dynapon, and he met all the directors, and each of the directors, they gave him their name cards.
帕帕德去日本，然后他去日本的大日本印刷的公司叫 Dynapon， 然后他就把 Krishna 的卡片发给每一个人。
So then Prabhupada had a big stack of name cards, and the youngest man, the smallest director, his name card was on the bottom.
然后呢，就是有一个 Prabhupada giving them card or they are giving Prabhupada's card.
They give Prabhupada.
对不起，他们给帕帕德他们自己的名片，然后其中有一个小的一个经理吧，或者是一个主任，他的名字印在这个名片的最下面。
And the main man, the managing director, his name card's on the top.
然后主要的那个经理，他的名片在最上面。
Right, the CEO, right?
CEO.
Chief Executive Officer.
行政主就是主要的这个主管。
So his card was on the top, and Prabhupada met all the directors, and now after he met them all, they went off, and he was left with the youngest man.
帕帕德见所有的这些主管，然后呢，见了所有的主管之后，最后留下来的是这个最小的，这个最年轻的人。
So Prabhupada was talking to him and he asked him, what is your goal in life?
帕帕德跟他交谈，然后就问道，你生命的目标是什么？
So the man took his name card out from the bottom and he put it on the top.
于是这个人从这一摞名片的最底下拿出自己的名片，然后放在最上面。
My goal in life is to be on the top.
我的生命的目标就是达到顶端。
So that is the mode of the material world.
这就是物质世界的情感。
Everyone's trying to be the controller.
每一个人试图成为控制者。
How many people can be on the top?
有多少人能够待在顶部？
How long can you be on the top?
你能够在顶部待多久？
Even who was that guy? See the apple CEO. What was his name?
那个苹果公司。
苹果公司啊。
Steve Jobs.
Steve Jobs, right? Steve Jobs, right? One minute he was the manager, next minute he was kicked out. You know, they kicked him out.
上一分钟他还是经理，下一分钟他就被踢出去了。
Then they brought him back, and.
后来他们又把他找回来。
The material world is like that, you know, it's very unstable, uncertain.
物质世界就是那个样子，特别不稳定。
Can never please everyone.
永远不能取悦每一个人。
Nobody's cooperating, there's no harmony, there's no mood of helping each other.
没有人跟你合作，他们没有这种一起合作、互相帮助的这种精神。
But in Krishna consciousness, we're trying to create the perfect atmosphere.
可是在 Krishna 知觉之中，我们想努力地创造完美的这种氛围。
People working together in harmony.
人们一起在和谐之中工作。
Prabhupada calls it the Ishavasya Society.
Prabhupada 管这个叫做 Ishavasya 社会。
With Krishna in the center.
Krishna 在中心。
So if you're Krishna conscious, then you can live very happily in this material world.
如果你们有 Krishna 知觉的话，那就可以快乐地生活在这个物质世界里。
And if you're Krishna conscious,then you want to work in the Krishna consciousness movement.
如果你有 Krishna 知觉的话，你就想在 Krishna 知觉运动之中工作。
We won't promise you that you will be rich.
我们不能答应你一定会变得很富有。
But you will be rich spiritually.
但是你可以在灵性上变得很富有。
You will be peaceful.
你会很平和。
You will be happy.
你会很快乐。
And you can feel satisfied that you've done something useful with your life.
而且你会感觉到你已经把你的生命用于做一个有用处的事情，你感觉很平衡。
But you give your life to the material world, what do you have to show?
但如果你把你的生命献给物质世界，你能得到什么？
Your car is going to get old quickly.
你的车很快会变旧。
Your bank balance will be left when you leave the body.
你的银行存款在你离开躯体的时候也会被留在身后。
You can't take a penny with you.
你一分钱也带不走。
It's all finished.
全都完蛋了。
But if you've done service for Krishna, it's for your eternal benefit.
但如果你们能够为 Krishna 做服务，这是为了你的永恒的好处。
It goes to your spiritual bank account.
这个会存在你的灵性的银行账户里。
But your material bank account, that is finished with the body.
你的物质的银行账户会随着你的身体的终结而结束。
We want to understand the importance of spiritual activities.
我们想去理解灵性活动的重要性。
And if you can start in the beginning of life, that's the best time.
如果你能够在生命的一开始就开始，那就是最好的时间。
Prahlad Maharaj said, from the age of Kumar, when you're a very young boy, you must begin.
Prahlad Maharaj 说，从你是 Kumar 的这个年龄段，就是你还是特别小的小孩的时候就开始。
Srila Prabhupada was born in devotee family.
Srila Prabhupada 出生在奉献者的家庭。
And Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati also was born in devotee family.
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 他也出生在奉献者的家庭。
So if you get that good birth, then it's very helpful.
如果你们能够有这么好的出生，会很有帮助。
That you have from your previous life, you have the good karma.
这就证明你们的前一世就有好的 karma.
And you should go on, make your life successful.
你应该继续让你自己的生命取得成功。
What is success?
成功是什么？
Just to make a lot of money?
只是挣很多的钱吗？
Money is...It opens the door into sinful activities.
金钱会打开通往罪恶活动的大门。
You get money, we want to use it for sinful life.
你得到金钱之后，就会把它用于罪恶的生活。
But if we use the money, if we get some money, use it for Krishna, then it's for eternal benefit.
但如果我们把钱为 Krishna 而花的话，那样我们就会得到永恒的好处。
So we need young men to come to this Krishna consciousness movement.
所以我们需要年轻人加入我们的 Krishna 知觉运动。
Take up this Krishna conscious lifestyle.
要接受这种 Krishna 知觉的生活方式
and preach this message of Krishna consciousness
并且传播这个 Krishna 知觉运动的信息
take it around the world
把它传遍全世界
Srila Prabhupada went around the world in his old age
师父帕帕德在他非常年迈的时候在全世界旅行
but if you can take up the preaching work when you're young it will be much better
但如果你能够在年轻的时候就接受 Krishna 知觉的话那会好得多
Then in your old age you can sit down and chant Hare Krishna
然后等你老了就可以坐下来唱诵 Hare Krishna
So we encourage the youth are the jewel of the society
所以我们非常的欢迎并且鼓励年轻人他们是我们这个协会的珍宝
That they have theOpportunity and early in their life to take up Krishna consciousness.
他们有机会可以在生命的早期接受 Krishna 知觉。
Of course, sometimes, often we find the mother and the father are not very favorable.
当然，有的时候我们会发现父亲或者是母亲他们并不是很乐意。
They will say, "Oh, when he gets older, let him get old, then he can be a devotee."
他们会说哎呀等他再长大一点然后他会成为一个奉献者。
But if you wait till the old age, you may not be able to do anything.
但如果你等着你变老了那你什么也做不了了。
Srila Prabhupada was giving sannyas to a number of young men in Mayapur one year.
有一年Srila Prabhupada在马雅普启迪很多年轻人成为sannyasi。
So one of Prabhupada's friends had come to see the ceremony.
帕帕德有一个朋友来看这个仪式
and he was watching and he saw all these young men take sannyas and he said to Srila Prabhupada he said oh they're all very young
他看着这个仪式就是参加的都是年轻人然后他说哦他们都很年轻啊
but Prabhupada said to this elderly man he said if we wait until they're old men what can they do?
帕帕德就跟他这个朋友说如果我们等了他们全都变老了那那时候他们能做什么呀
In old age, everything is so difficult to do.
在年迈的时候你做任何事情都非常的艰难
But when you're young, you have energy, you have life, you can use it for Krishna.
但当你年轻的时候你有能量然后你有很多的力气你可以把这些都用于 Krishna.
And you get the benefit, the eternal benefit.
你可以得到永恒的好处
Goes into your spiritual bank account.
这个会被存进你的灵性的银行账号里。
Devotion, whatever progress you've made in devotional service, never lose it.
在奉献服务之中，你取得的进步永远不会失去。
Even if you only make 2% progress in Krishna consciousness, you'll never lose that.
即使你在 Krishna 知觉之中只取得了2%的进步，你也永远不会失去。
You go on from that point. You go on. You continue.
从这一点，你可以继续，你接着往下走。
But if you leave it till later in life,
但如果你留着想等着老了再说
，You don't know what will be the situation.
你也不知道到时候情况怎么样。
So the saying in Sanskrit, they say, Subhasya Sigram, the auspicious thing should be done immediately.
在梵文之中我们说 Subhasya Sigram, 吉祥的事情应该尽早做。
Something which is for the service of Krishna, we don't hesitate about that. We should immediately take it up.
为了服务 Krishna 的事情我们不应该等待我们应该立刻接受去做
The material thought, material activities we will hesitate No
物质的想法物质的活动我们可以去犹豫不
But spiritual, something for Krishna, for devotional service We should be eager, we should take it up
但是灵性的东西然后我们应该非常迫切的去接受
So we're encouraging all you young men, take up Krishna consciousness very seriously.
所以我们鼓励你们所有的年轻人要很认真地对待 Krishna 知觉。
And you'll never regret.
而且你永远不会后悔。
But you go into the material world, you'll endeavor. You cannot expect to get success.
但如果你留在物质世界里，你去努力，再努力，再努力，你永远不能指望着成功。
You may build a big empire, everything will be lost.
可能你会建立整个的一个帝国，但所有的一切最后都会被失去。
So, any questions?
有什么问题吗？
Yes.
How to boost up enthusiasm time to time?
Uh-huh.
如何时不常的，就是让自己就更有力气，给自己鼓劲儿。
How to get enthusiasm? You have to associate with people who are enthusiastic.
你怎么能变得更有热情？你要跟那些非常有热情的人一起去联谊。
You have to go and get association with some of these nice devotees I was telling you about.
你应该去找到一些我告诉你的好奉献者，跟他们一起去联谊。
Kripa Sindhu Prabhu,
Shiva
Chaitanya
Prabhu,
Mahabharata
Prabhu.
They're all devotees from very young age and they're fully dedicated to Krishna consciousness.
他们都是很年轻就当了奉献者，而且完全的献身于 Krishna 之觉。
They've been practicing Krishna consciousness for more than 40 years.
他们都已经修习 Krishna 之觉超过四十年了。
And they're completely dedicated to Krishna's service.
他们完全把自己献身给对 Krishna 的服务。
So if you can get their association, you can become very enthusiastic.
如果你能得到他们的联谊，你也可以变得非常的有热情。
So association is important to get enthusiasm.
所以联谊是很重要的，这样你就可以得到热情。
But Srila Prabhupada also said, you want enthusiasm, just be enthusiastic.
而Srila Prabhupada也说过，你想变得有热情吗？只要你有热情，你就可以变得有热情。
And if you are enthusiastic,that you can enthuse others.
你如果很有热情，你也可以激励别人。
Why are you not enthusiastic?
你为什么没有热情啊？
Because you're listening to the mind, or you're thinking material things.
因为你在聆听心意，你在想着那些物质的东西。
We're absorbed on the mundane bodily platform.
我们就沉浸在这种世俗的躯体化的层面上。
You have to overcome these things. You have to come to the spiritual platform.
你必须要克服这些东西，你要达到灵性的层面。
You can be enthusiastic.
你可以变得有热情。
And Prabhupada told the story about how he had seen one film that was about this one man, Charlie Chaplin.
施罗帕帕德他给我们就是有一个故事，讲的是施罗帕帕德看了查理卓别林的电视剧。
So this Charlie Chaplin.What happened was, he was in the ballroom and he was at the dancing, and he ripped his jacket. His jacket got all ripped, a big rip in the back of the jacket.
这个查理卓别林在舞厅里跳舞，但是他的外套后面裂了一个大口子。
But he did not feel, my jacket's all ripped. He thought, I should become more enthusiastic.
但他没有因为自己的这个外套破了一个大口子而感觉到尴尬，他就觉得我应该更有热情。
So he went after he ripped his jacket, he came out and he started to dance with great enthusiasm around the ballroom.
于是他在舞厅里以更大的热情在拼命跳舞。
And everyone was, and people saw him, they all went and ripped their jackets.
然后所有的人看见他这个样子受到感染，把自己的外套也都撕了一大口子。
And they all came and they all started to dance like Charlie Chaplin.
然后他们都学着查理卓别林一样的去跳舞。
So if you are enthusiastic, it's very contagious. Other people also become enthused.
如果你要是很有热情的话，这个就会有感染力，你会激励其他的人也变得有热情。
I saw one skit, one thing on somewhere. Somebody showed me this film. It was in a train, and people were in the train, you know, and everyone was sitting, and everyone was very serious. And then all of a sudden, somebody else came into the compartment, and they started laughing and laughing, and they were, this one man was laughing, and he started laughing, and gradually everybody in the compartment, everyone started laughing.
别人还给我看过一个小电影，在电影里呢，就说有一些人坐在火车上，每个人都在那闷闷地坐着，非常的严肃。结果后来来了另外的人，另外的人他们就开始笑，他们笑得很开心，不停地笑啊笑啊，结果让所有的人都跟着一起笑。
The whole carriage, everybody.
整个车厢里的人都在拼命地笑。
So enthusiasm is like that.
这种热情也是一样的。
You go to the Kirtan, and everybody just.
你去参加 Kirtan, 所有的人都是。
And you start jumping and dancing, and then everybody else, and they also start to dance with you and join in with you.
你去在那个 Kirtan 里又蹦又跳，你就会感染别人，别人也会像你一样有热情，也开始又蹦又跳。
It's contagious.
就是很有感染力的。
No, Krishna consciousness is like that.
Krishna 知觉就像那样。
If we have Krishna consciousness, we can give it to others.
如果我们有 Krishna 知觉，我们也可以把它给别人。
So, this is how it works. Just like typhoid, there was this one girl, young woman, her name was Mary, and she had typhoid, and everywhere she went,She was spreading typhoid.
就像是伤寒，有一个姑娘，她的名字叫玛丽，她感染了伤寒病菌，她去所有的地方就把这个伤寒都传染给了别人。
So many people, where's the disease coming from?
很多人在奇怪，这病是从哪儿来的？
It's just one girl, everywhere she went, everybody got the disease.
就是这一个姑娘，她去的所有的地方，让每一个人都得了伤。
The same way devotee can go and give Krishna consciousness.
同样道理，奉献者们可以去派发 Krishna 知觉。
There's that quote in the ballroom downstairs that Prabhupada said, whether you're in Texas or China, our business is to contaminate the place with Krishna.
我们在楼下的大厅里呢，有一个释迦帕帕德的引文，其中他说，无论你是在德克萨斯还是在中国，就像是你可以要做生意一样，把那个地方给污染掉。
Prabhupada was thinking of China.
帕帕在想着中国。
You can contaminate everyone with Krishna.
你就用 Krishna 把每个人都给污染了。
But you have to have the enthusiasm to go there.
但你必须要有热情去那儿。
If you don't go there, it won't happen.
你不去那会怎么样？
If you go there, you'll get the credit.
如果你去，你就得到这个功德。
But if you don't go,
你如果不去
you don't get any credit.
你什么功德也得不到。
So we have to be enthusiastic, very important.
我们必须要很有热情，非常重要。
And the problem is our own mind.
问题就是我们自己的心意。
The mind doesn't want to do it. The mind is not enthusiastic.
心意不想做，心意一点也不热情。
We have to conquer the mind.
我们要征服我们的心意。
So this is enthusiasm.
这就是热情。
I want to do it for Krishna.
我想为 Krishna 而做。
You have to be enthusiastic.
你必须非常有热情。
Prabhupada had that enthusiasm to go to America.
帕帕德就有这样的热情去美国。
With no money.
没有钱。
And to go there and then to go out and to chant.
然后去了那儿之后再出去唱诵。
And to make a little center and have a program.
就是说造就一个小的中心做节目。
And to preach to the people.
去向人们传播。
So that enthusiasm is very important.
这种热情非常重要。
So the people coming to Krishna consciousness, they should have that enthusiasm.
进入 Krishna 知觉的人们应该都有这种热情。
Material life, we shouldn't be very enthusiastic for that.
我们不应该为物质的生活而感觉有热情。
We should be very doubtful about material world.
我们应该对物质世界充满疑惑。
But we should feel very confident that Krishna consciousness is offering a positive life.
但是我们应该非常的有信心 ，Krishna 知觉会为我们提供积极的生活。
You give your life to Krishna.
你把你的生活给 Krishna。
Give this one life. We've had so many lives. We never gave to Krishna.
把这一辈子给 Krishna. 我们之前有生生世世都从来没给过 Krishna.
Now give this one life to Krishna.
现在就把这一辈子给 Krishna.
No harm.
没有害处。
Everything to gain, nothing to lose.
只有收获，没有损失。
All right, any other question?
可以吗？有其他问题吗？
So even older people, they can also commit themselves to Krishna consciousness.
即使是老人，他们也可以承诺让他们自己加入 Krishna 知觉。
It's better late than never.
迟到总比没有好。
Right? In the Srimad Bhagavatam, we have examples of people like Ajamila in their old age also becoming God conscious.
在 Srimad Bhagavatam 之中有阿加密拉的例子，他虽然很年迈，他都变成了具有 Krishna 知觉。
And Chitraketu, he became a demon, but he became fully conscious of Krishna.
Chitraketu 虽然他成为了恶魔，但他完全知觉到 Krishna。
So sometimes even it takes the next life before people become Krishna conscious.
所以有的时候对于人们来讲，他还要再花一辈子的时间，下一辈子都搭进去，才能有 Krishna 知觉。
At any stage in life, Prahlad Maharaj was in the womb. He was so fortunate.
不过在人们的任何的生命的阶段，比如说 Prahlad Maharaj, 他在母亲子宫之中就得到了机会，他非常幸运。
Dhruva Maharaj was a young boy. He went to the forest.
Dhruva Maharaj 是一个小男孩，他就去了森林。
And became Krishna conscious.
变成了具有 Krishna 知觉的人。
So at any point in the life, you can become Krishna conscious.
在生命之中的任何阶段，你都可以变得具有 Krishna 知觉。
But that we encourage, the sooner you do it, the better it is.
但如果你越早做，那就结果越好。
You have more time to commit yourself, to dedicate yourself fully to Krishna's service.
这样你就有更多的时间让自己完全献身于对 Krishna 的服务。
We see Jayapataka Swami Maharaj, he was a sannyasi since he was 19 years old.
我们看到 Jayapataka Maharaj, 他十九岁的时候就开始做了 sannyasi。
So dedicated his whole life for Krishna.
他把他自己的一生都献给了 Krishna.
And even in his poor health condition, he's still giving so much Krishna consciousness.
即使是现在他的健康状况很糟糕，他仍然在不断的去给别人 Krishna 知觉。
Okay.Any other question?
还有其他问题吗？
Everybody agrees?
大家都同意吗？
Right? Yeah. You're going to give your son to Krishna?
你们把你们的儿子给 Krishna 吗？
可以。
他们不要的，
我
的。What about if they don't take?
I was in one lady's house.And I said to her, why don't you give your son to Krishna? She said, oh, they can go. I don't want them. She said, let them go.
我在玉女士家里，我就问说，为什么不把你儿子给 Krishna? 她说，哦，我不想要他了，他们可以走。
But of course, the young boys were not eager to go.
当然了，那些年轻的小伙子们，他们不愿意走。
And the mother was saying, yeah, they can go. I don't want them. They're useless.
母亲说他们可以走，他们我不想要他们，他们没有用处。
But still, the boys were living off the mother.
但仍然呢，这些年轻人他们就是啃老。
So, sometimes, often difficult to get both sides to agree. Sometimes the children want to become devotees, the parents don't want them to go.
很难让双方都同意，有的时候这个孩子同意，但是父母不愿意让他们走。
Other times when the parents want them to go, the children don't want to go.
还有的时候呢，是父母想让他们走，这孩子不愿意走。
And difficult to get people.
很难让人们。
However, we see, Malaysia at least we got people like Shiva Chaitanya Prabhu and.Kripa Sindhu Prabhu, Mahabharaha Prabhu, and so many others, they became Krishna conscious, their parents were favorable, they allowed their children to become devotees.
不过我们可以看到在马来西亚有 Shiva Chaitanya Prabhu, 有 Kripa Sindhu Krishna Prabhu, 还有 Mahabharaha Prabhu, 他们的父母都很支持他们，赞成他们。
So they were fortunate, they had that opportunity.
他们非常的幸运，能够有这样的机会。
And they took the opportunity. They never went back to the material life.
他们抓住了这个机会，再没有回到物质生活之中。
So it's very nice to get people the earlier, the better. The younger they are, the better we can train them.
所以让他们越早加入越好，我们就可以越多的给他们训练。
And we see, for example, among the Buddhists, they have very young Buddhist monks.
我们可以在这个佛教的寺庙之中看到他们有很小的和尚。
So we have also, of course, Gurukula. We have young children in the Gurukula.
当然了，我们有 Gurukula. Gurukula 里都是小孩。
And these boys, as they grow up, then they can do everything. They've learned everything.
当这些孩子们长大之后，他们可以做所有的一切，他们已经学了所有的一切。
They know everything, all the deity worship.
他们了解所有神像崇拜的一切细节。
They play all the instruments.
他们可以演奏所有的乐器。
They've learned all the slokas.
他们已经学会了所有的 sloka.
They can give classes.
他们可以讲课。
They lead all the kirtans.
可以领唱所有的 kirtan.
So many of them, they go off and they become the temple president.
他们很多的人，他们毕业之后都成为了庙长。
Look after the temples because they can do everything.
照顾庙宇是因为他们可以做所有的一切。
We open temples and we have people all new. They don't know anything, can't do anything.
我们有时候开办庙宇就会发现有很多的人很新，他们什么都不知道，什么也做不了。
But if you get the boys who've been trained up in the Gurukula, then they can do everything. They know everything.
但如果你得到从 Gurukula 毕业的这些小伙子们，他们已经知道了所有的一切，他们什么都能做。
And they can train the other people up.
他们还可以培训其他的人。
But these boys from the Gurukula, not very many.
但是 Gurukula 里培养出来的孩子并不多。
We don't have many Gurukulas.
我们没有很多的 Gurukula 们。
And often the boys grow up, then many of them, they're still there in Mayapur. They're taking up jobs in Mayapur, in the temple there.
当这些孩子们长大之后呢，他们就留在了 Mayapur, 在 Mayapur 工作。
But some of the boys from overseas countries, they go back to their own country, and then they can take up nice activities, helping.In the temple.
但是有一些从西方国家来的孩子们，他们在 Gurukula 毕业之后，回到自己原本的地方，就可以发挥作用，然后照顾一些庙宇。
So they're happy. These boys are very happy there.
这些孩子们是很快乐的。
They've learned everything nicely, and they can teach it to others.
他们很好的学习了所有的一切，而且他们可以去教别人。
Okay. Any other question?
还有其他问题吗？
Okay. Thank you very much. If there are no questions, we'll finish here.
非常感谢大家。如果没有问题，我们就到此结束了。